Hi guys, I've got another unboxing to do, but first of all I just want to show you something. This is more for Grumpy and for Serene. The reason why I can't do anything at the minute, it's been like this for days, is there's 30-40 mile an hour gusts. And if I try and light a charcoal forge in this, which I've got to do outside obviously, I'm either going to be eating hot embers, the neighbours are going to be eating hot embers, or you're not going to get stuff heat treated properly. And it's been like this for days now. But yeah, not much I can do. I have chased up the propane forge, expecting an email this afternoon telling me exactly where it is. So yeah, we'll see what happens. So let's see what we've got in these. That's not a bad match. That's pretty good. There we go. All my knives are going to come with lanyards now. This is for me so I can get spacings right, but also I might do a bulk buy of them. That is a Techlock belt loop. What's it called? I can't actually remember. Ha! There we go. Blade Tech, the clip. That was it. Stumble there. It's got Caddx outlet in it. Yep. So I'm going to see what they're like. And I wanted to get a new belt as well. Seeing as I'm getting fat now. Also, I wanted to see how well that fits. I don't really have it all. Oh, look at that. That's nice. Yep, there we go. What else have we got? Is. Oh well, makes it more exciting. As long as it's not. Lots of bubble wrap. I'd forgotten all about these. You know what they are? I've got too many offcuts lying around. I've been wanting to do this for a while and finally found somewhere that was a half decent price. So we've got five big 10mm Rossi rods. I don't think it'll work on this. No, I didn't think so. Stainless. This, I think, should have some toys in it. Some knife making toys. Hey, Brother Marshall. End poo. Poo. Oh, even more end poo. Ah, oh, that was a wet one. All right, what have we got here? Other than end poo. If you don't know what an ent is, go watch Lord of the Rings. Let's see what this is first. Now this is because I had a near miss with my drill press. Bloody hell, that's big. I didn't think it was going to be that big. Holy shit. Yeah, I had something helicopter on me the other day. And also, I'm sure I'll find a use for it. But I was expecting that to be a third of the size. Oh well. Blades for my bandsaw. 1/4 inch by 10 TPI. These aren't very pitch. That's for G10. And Makarta, that's for making G10 slingshots. And 1/4 inch with 6 TPI variable. And that's for making slingshots, but out of wood. Proper 1/4 inch drill bit. Scott, Base Fury 6, Wessex blades. I got that on your tip. Custom order that somebody's asked me to do for them. Now this is what I'm really interested in, so we'll leave that till last. This, now, when you're drilling through carbon fibre and G10, it's not very easy. I used what's called a wood beaver. All I did was modify the screw on the end so it didn't have as much pull, and that goes through G10 and carbon fiber like cheese. And then they brought a new one out and I needed to replace mine anyway. And this is a bimetal one. It's made for cutting through wood with nails in it. Cutting through G10 and carbon fibre is probably not that much different to cutting through wood with nails in it. So that, in theory, should last me quite a long time. It's not really, I don't know if it's zooming in and focusing there. Apologise if it isn't. But that is how you do a pinky hole in G10 and carbon fibre. This is a new hole cutter. Now I've been using Bosch hole saws. They don't last 2 minutes. This was expensive. Oh, in fact, I'll show you this at the same time, actually. There's the wood beaver. You can see the section at the end there where it's a separate metal, it's bimetal. That's for pinky holes and catapults. That's a beast of a tool, that. Need to modify it though. Need to remove these drive screw, this drive screw on here, otherwise it just rams into the pilot hole and you end up with a helicopter of a slingshot. And this is what I was really after. This is a tungsten carbide tipped hole cutter, which in theory should leave extremely clean holes and is easily sharpenable by the look of it. That's an inch, as near as damn it. And that's primarily for karambit and for doing finger choils in the cookery that I'm going to make when the steel comes. Span shank in the background, guys. You still watching? Thank you very much. And the camera's not doing this justice.